Welcome to another edition of the Carolina Bay of the Day, where we study the secondary impacts made by the glacierized boulders that were ejected by an extraterrestrial impact on the Laurentide ice sheet. This is part one of a trilogy about the Carolina Bays of Hoke County, North Carolina. In this part, we will be paying attention to the use of the land where the Carolina Bays are found. Hoke County is located in North Carolina's coastal plain region in an area originally inhabited by Cherokee and Lumbee Indians. The county is about 150 kilometers or 93 miles from the Atlantic coast. The county seat is the city of Rareford, which is located between Fayetteville and Loringburg. Also, a portion of the Fort Bragg Military Reservation is within Hoke County. According to the U.S. Census Bureau, the county has a total area of 392 square miles or 1,020 square kilometers. This is a LiDAR image of an area near Bowmore, North Carolina, that I selected because it shows many different features that are typical of Carolina Bays. The area measures 3.6 kilometers by 7.3 kilometers, which is about 26 square kilometers or 10 square miles. The image represents less than 3% of the area of Hoke County, so it is only a small sample. You will find the link to the LiDAR visualization tool for Google Earth by Michael Davias in the description of the video. The satellite view of the same area shows roads crisscrossing a landscape of farm fields and forested areas. The land does not have any large urban centers. The outlines of a few Carolina Bays can be seen in this image, but LiDAR images are necessary to study the Carolina Bays. This LiDAR image shows a rectangular feature near a bay that has a width of 450 meters and a length of 681 meters, which is about 4/10 of a mile. A satellite image of the same area shows that the rectangular feature is a complex of barns. Larger magnification shows 8 barns and several auxiliary buildings. A trapezoidal area to the north of the buildings is probably a waste disposal pool for the farm animals. All the barn buildings could easily fit within one of the bays. This provides some perspective about the size of the bays. We will now shift our attention to the small bay that is on the edge of the road. The LiDAR image shows that road 401 crosses the rim of the small bay, which has a width of 300 meters and a length of 420 meters. The satellite image shows a market called Hilltop's Finest close to the small bay. The street view of the Hilltop's Finest market shows that the market is on a gentle hill, which is the rim of the small bay. Maybe this small hilltop inspired the name of the market. Google Maps has some information about Hilltop's Finest market. One of the reviews says that Hilltop's Finest is a very nice produce market with a good selection. Another reviewer says that he bought some turnips, cabbage, local wagram honey, and a lot of local pickles. A third reviewer says that the produce is always fresh and the staff is very friendly. Now we know where to get good produce when we visit this area. When we look at the Carolina Bays, we frequently come across some unusual man-made structures. Zooming the LiDAR image sometimes does not help much because the date of the LiDAR images is different from the date of the satellite images. This image has a rectangular area with raised rims. In this case, the satellite image shows 8 barns aligned in a row and the rectangular area is adjacent to the barns. At greater magnification, we can see that the 8 buildings are surrounded by plowed fields and the rectangular area with raised rims seems to be a pond for disposing of farm animal waste. This farm is close to the road, and we can use Google Street View to see the buildings. Google Maps identifies this location as the Hoke Livestock Farm, and from the highway we can see a trailer with window air conditioners. A red car is parked by the trailer, and a black pickup truck is parked by the nearby trees. In the background, we see the barns and grain storage silos. This is a fairly common sight in rural North Carolina. The silos hold the feed for the animals that are housed inside the barns. The floors of the barn are covered with sawdust or wood chips to make cleaning easier, and fans blow constantly to bring fresh air into the building. By exploring the Carolina Bays, we get to see parts of America that normally would be very far away from our thoughts. Every time that we eat bacon and eggs, buy some fried chicken, or when we celebrate a holiday with a turkey dinner, we should keep in mind the farmers who make their livelihood on the Carolina Bays of North Carolina. Thank you for joining me in the exploration of the Carolina Bays. I will continue to examine the Carolina Bays one bay at a time. My book about the Carolina Bays is available at Amazon. The next episode of the Hoke County Trilogy will examine the elliptical geometry of the bays and calculate the energy of the impacts that created them. Please subscribe to be notified of future videos about the Carolina Bays.